In this video, we're going to present a short explanation of an important concept in thermodynamics, namely that of state function. So, really is one of the most useful concepts in thermo. And the idea is that for a state variable, and we'll talk about what state variable is, the pathway does not matter. So, for example, on some pressure volume diagram, we go from A to B. There's one pathway, there's a second, there's a third, then delta H is the same, delta S is the same, delta U, delta V, delta G, delta A. So enthalpy change, entropy change, S, internal energy change, and this was supposed to be delta V, volume change, Gibbs free energy change, Helmholtz free energy change. The change from A to B is independent of the pathway. And thus, the important idea is that we pick the pathway that makes the calculations easy. So, for example, we have a reaction where reactant A at 600 degrees centigrade goes to product B at 600 degrees centigrade. And we want to know what's the heat of reaction at 600. Well, we don't have tables that list heats of reaction 600. What we can do is say, let's start with A at 600. Let's cool A down to 25 and calculate delta H1. So delta H1 is going to be integral from 600 to 25, the heat capacity of A dt. We then carry out the reaction to form B at 25 degrees C. So that's delta H2. Well, delta H2 is delta H of the reaction at 25 degrees C, and that's equal to heat of formation B at 25 degrees C minus the heat of formation of A at 25 degrees C. And these heats of formation are in tables. So we can look those up. And then we're going to want to take the product B and heat it up to 600 degrees C and calculate delta H3. So delta H3 is the integral from 25 to 600, the heat capacity of B, integrated over T. And so then delta H for the reaction at 600 C, that's what we're interested in, is delta H1 plus delta H2 plus delta H3. And we pick this alternate pathway because we can find heat capacities for A, we can find the heat of reaction at 25 degrees C from tables, and we can find the heat capacity of B. So keep in mind there are things that we use a lot in thermo, like W and Q. These are not state functions. They depend on the pathway rather dramatically. Remember, state function means if I go, I'm going to say a TP diagram. If I go from A to B by reversible pathway, and I go from A to B by irreversible pathway for some gas, then delta S for reversible pathway is the same as delta S for the irreversible pathway. Remember, this is for the gas. We're not talking about delta S total of the system plus surroundings. We're just saying for the gas that we're looking at, we're going from A to B by two pathways. I'm going to have the same delta S for the gas, independent of whether one is reversible and one is irreversible. The other thing to keep in mind, we're working with S and H and U and G. We're, in general, only interested in changes. We don't work with absolute values for H, U, and G. Instead, we pick some reference, such as in the steam tables. For S, it would be possible to have absolute S values, but in general, that's not what we're working with. So again, as in the steam tables, we pick some reference for S. It's only changes that we're dealing with. So just to summarize, if we want to calculate a property change, you know, like entropy, enthalpy, internal energy, we can replace the actual path, the actual pathway, the actual process, by any other process that accomplishes the same change in state. Namely, any other process that goes from the same initial to the same final condition we can use because we can pick a process to make our calculations easy.